news, Tinubu observes prayers at Dodan Barracks Prayer Ground, Lagos, urges Nigerians to shun ethnic and religious rivalries. Lagos residents lament high cost of food items during Sallah celebration. And INEC condemns European Union's Election Observation Mission report, says judgment unfair. Many thanks for joining us on News Now on TV 360 Nigeria. I am Sinisola Adigun. President Bola Tinubu has urged Nigerians to have faith in God as they pray for peace and stability as well as prosperity. Speaking to reporters after observing the Eid al-Kabir prayers at Dodan Barracks Prayer Ground, the president said the need for unity and cooperation is important while appealing to Nigerians to eschew ethnic and religious rivalries. The president also used the occasion to pray for Nigerian troops at the front line in the fight against insurgency, saying it is his earnest desire that the nation emerges victorious. Tinubu also urged citizens to face their future with renewed hope and vigor. Meanwhile, Lagos State Deputy Governor Obafemi Hamzat, on behalf of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu, asked Nigerians to support President Tinubu in his determination to improve the country.
May our sacrifices turn to prosperity. We have to make the sacrifices. And that is clear. If we have to. But Allah will not give you a burden that you cannot carry. Will not. It's there for you. Have faith in the country. Have faith in yourself, believing that you, as a citizen of this country, you must join hands. No religious identity, no tribal identity. Live with one another in joy and prosperity. It will come. Nigeria will see peace, stability, and God will grant peace to those of us who are in the war front. We spare their life. We give them victory. Those in the hospitals, we give them succor and peace.
The Chief Zonal Missioner, Nasfat Lagos Zone 2, Abdulrasheed Ashamo, has called on Nigerians to spread love and live in unity on the occasion of this year's Eid al-Kabir. While offering thanks to God for another year, the missioner urged Muslim faithful in the country to imbibe the spirit of tolerance and forgiveness, irrespective of tribe or religion. He further called for support for the Bola Tinubu administration. Also speaking at the prayer ground, former Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, urged Nigerians to intensify their prayers for the socio-economic development of the nation. The former minister emphasized that only the collective efforts of stakeholders could bring about the desired change envisioned for the nation.
All Muslims should see ourselves as one, irrespective of the society that we belong to. So that is the message to every one of us, and to be prayerful for the government of Asuaju Tinubu, so that he will attain success throughout his tenure, and be prayerful for the whole nation too, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will sustain our nation, Nigeria, so that we'll be able to live in peace and harmony.
What we're celebrating today is remembering our forefathers. That's the prophet Ibrahim. How he made a promise to Allah, and he was ready to fulfill that promise. Allah saw his intention and said, no, I won't take your child from you. I'll replace it with a ram. Look at the magnanimity of Almighty Allah. If he had not done that, many of us would not be alive today.
Embrace everybody. We are all equal in the presence of Almighty Allah. We are all equal. If you go to Kaaba now, no matter who you are, you tawaf together, you do everything together, which shows we are all one. Let's take ourselves as one and live in peace and endure and be patient. There's no hurry in life. If you ask something from Almighty Allah, if he did not give you, he has a reason for not giving you. But he has given you something in replacement of that thing you asked for.
As Muslim faithful celebrate this year's Eid al-Kabir festival in commemoration of Prophet Ibrahim's obedience to Allah, there is a noticeable hike in the cost of rams, which is one of the crucial items of the celebration. Some Muslim faithful who spoke to TV 360 Nigeria at the Ashade Market, Magoro, Agege, lamented the hike in food items, which they say has gone up by 100%. The customers say that the prevailing circumstances of the country, and not just the festival, triggered the increase. On their part, traders at the market cited difficulty in moving their goods to the point of sale as a major challenge. Our correspondent, Sydney Okafor, has more details in this report.
Prices of food items tend to rise as the Eid Kabir approaches, and this year is no different. When 65-year-old Adekunle Ayinde approached ram seller here at Ashade Market in Magoro, he was stunned at how price of rams had more than doubled.
I only come to buy this ram for Salah. And my expectation is not worth something to write about. That of last year that we are complaining that the money was higher. The one they are selling now, even a ram of under 8 months, they said it's over 200,000.
Ile has always been an expensive period, but this year seems to be the most I've experienced, the most expensive I've experienced. So an average ram that we used to buy for like 150, 200, is like almost times two of the cost from the market survey I've done so far.
Right here, you can see that everywhere is filled up with different sizes of ram, and a lot of Muslim faithful has come over here to purchase what they know that they can afford to celebrate this year Eid Kabir festival.
Slaughtering a ram is key to fulfilling the Islamic rites for the celebration of Eid Kabir festival, but the economy reality bites hard for many of these buyers. Danladi Shuaibu, a ram dealer, attributed the high price of ram to the economy meltdown as well as acute logistic problems experienced from the north to the southern part of the country.
Our money, is very go down. Cipher, Niger money, before we are buying that Niger money, 350. Now it's 1,180 to 1,002. Before, after that, the transport is very expensive. Last year, they bring ram here, 4,000, 4,500. Now it's going to 12,000 for one ram from Nigeria. They are paying like 1.8.
Gaskiya kasuwan yayi yana yi kyau kuma gashi dabobi inda ake sayarwa kamar 80 90 100 haka suke sayarwa ba wani za a ce 200 200 ku babu su. Gaskiya kwasomomi suna zuwa sosai kamar wanda yafi bara suna zuwa suna siya.
Beyond hike in cost of food items, the transportation sector has also seen a surge in price. At Oba Motor Park, passengers traveling from Lagos to Ijebu Ode and Ibadan by road grumbled about the 100% rise in bus fare.
The price is unjustified, because the reason why it's like that is because they remove the subsidy totally from us. And before that, we are taking this bus from here to Ibadan, nothing less than 2,000, 2,500, that's it. But now it's 5,000, and it's unbearable.
Before it is 2,005, but now it's now 3,005, which I feel is very expensive. Not everybody can afford it. That's why people are not traveling. Like me, I'm still going to Epe. But I just have to pass through Igebu because of the bad road.
Despite harsh economic realities, Muslim faithful still find a means to observe this year's Eid Kabir festival with their loved ones as they also plead with the government to intervene on the lingering hardship in the country. Sydney Okafor, TV360 News, Lagos.
The Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, has assured Nigeria is on course to achieving optimal democracy. INEC National Commissioner for Information and Voter Education, Festus Okoye, spoke on Tuesday in response to the European Union Election Observation Mission's final report on the recently concluded general election. Barry Andrews, the chief observer, said the elections exposed enduring systemic weaknesses that need to be corrected. Andrews faulted INEC for the operational challenges and glitches experienced with the bimodal voter accreditation system, BVAS, saying the discrepancies severely damaged public confidence in the electoral body. Reacting to the report, Okoye said it is unfair to judge the commission and the entirety of the polls based on a few glitches. He added that other domestic and international observers had attested that in terms of voter accreditation, the BVAS machine performed optimally. Troops of 5 Battalion operating under 16th Brigade of the Nigerian Army have captured an armory located in the Azuzuama community in Ijo South local government area of Bayelsa State, where suspected unrepentant militant and illegal oil bunkers carry out their nefarious activities. According to a statement by the Director of Army Public Relations, Brigadier General Oyema Onwachukwu, the raid was carried out on Sunday, June 25. Oyema said during the operation, the troops subdued the suspected militants with superior firepower, compelling them to abandon their camp. According to him, the well-conducted raid operation led to the recovery of 5 AK-47 rifles, 2 rocket-propelled grenade bombs, 4 rocket grenade bomb charges, 7.62mm special ammunition, 14 AK-47 rifle magazines, and 1 pumping machine. As part of efforts to support the federal government's plans to achieve net zero carbon emission in Nigeria by 2060, a coalition of civil society organizations in Lagos have tasked journalists to raise public awareness on cutting carbon emissions in the country to net zero. The one-day media training and interactive session, which involved a presentation on net zero emission by climate and environmental experts, had organizers calling for more focus on energy transition from the use of greenhouse gases to renewable energy by the government. This next report has more details.
Present at the first-of-its-kind press conference organized by the Center for 21st Century Issues, International Climate Change Development Initiative and Connected Advocacy on raising awareness of cutting carbon emissions to net zero emission in Nigeria, at the executive directors of the three collaborating organizations, environmental experts and concerned citizens. Cutting down carbon emissions to net zero has been on the front burner in Nigeria, with past administrations making commitments and pledges to cut down emissions. The former President Muhammadu Buhari-led government had in November 2021 announced that Nigeria, alongside other world's largest energy exporters, will eliminate planet warming emissions by 2060. These warnings need to be reiterated, and the International Climate Change Development Initiative Africa has called on the media and local communities at this event tagged Vance Nigeria Project to develop strategies in adopting renewable energy transition plans.
Everyone is talking about carbon neutrality. That simply implies that net zero emission, that is what the entire world should drive to. And in talking about that, you recall we are developing the long-term low emission development strategy that will enable Nigeria to follow that trajectory. And so that is all that we're doing, and interestingly, we're reaching out to every stakeholders. I also had mentioned earlier that we developed a long-term vision which was submitted to the UNFCCC Secretariat, and that became part of the citizens report released by that Secretariat last year before COP27. And now we're developing the strategy that will assist us in ensuring that we're able to decarbonize our economy. But of course, while decarbonizing our economy, we also want to recognize that there is need to build climate resilience.
Offering solutions to avert future catastrophes, organizers of the event say it's collaboration with private sectors will achieve the Paris Agreement made by the government.
There's no sector that is not affected or that is not going to be, you know, left out when it comes to the net zero issue in this country, because the kind of population, the kind of growth that we are seeing now in our development, we need to see how we can reduce drastically our emission. And that is why net zero will be discussed in all these sectors, whether you are in oil and gas, agriculture, energy, you know, transportation. So it's very, very important.
If we don't reduce greenhouse gas emissions into the atmosphere, then we may not be able to stop catastrophic climate change. So it's an alarming sign to all of us that it is not only about developed countries only, it is also about developing countries. All of us must contribute to reducing carbon emissions so that we will not suffer the impacts of climate change.
Summing up the event, the civil society organizations urge the public to take actions for deep emission reduction in Nigeria, as it would help grow the Nigerian economy. Tamilore Akinkolia, TV 360 Nigeria.
The Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission, ICPC, says it will appeal a court verdict ordering the immediate release of Dibu Ojerinde, the ex-registrar of the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board, JAMB. The ICPC had accused the ex-JAMB boss of diverting public funds to the tune of 5 billion naira and dragged him before Justice Egwatu on an 18-count charge money laundering suit. On Tuesday, a federal high court Abuja awarded a 1 million naira fine against the ICPC for the unlawful detention of Ojerinde and a 200 naira fine as Ojerinde's cost of instituting the case. Consequently, Justice Egwatu, who declared that Ojerinde is presumed innocent until the court decides, ordered his immediate release or arraignment. We'll take a break now, but still to come, Wuhan researcher alleges China engineered COVID-19 bioweapon to purposely infect people. There are details of the story when we return. Welcome back. Let's have a quick recap of our top stories. President Bola Tinubu has urged Nigerians to have faith in God as they pray for peace and stability as well as prosperity. Speaking to reporters after observing the Idil Kabir prayers at Dodan Barracks prayer ground, the president said the need for unity and cooperation is important while appealing to Nigerians to shun ethnic and religious rivalries. The president also used the occasion to pray for Nigerian troops at the front line and the fight against insurgency, saying it is his earnest desire that the nation emerges victorious. We also told you that the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, has assured that Nigeria is on course to achieving optimal democracy. INEC National Commissioner for Information and Voter Education, Festus Okoye, spoke on Tuesday in response to the European Union Election Observation Mission's final report on the recently concluded general election. Barry Andrews, the chief observer, said the elections exposed enduring systemic weaknesses on the part of INEC that need to be corrected. Reacting to the report, Okoye said it is unfair to judge the commission and the entirety of the polls based on a few glitches, adding that other domestic and international observers attested that in terms of voter accreditation, the Beavers machine performed optimally. Now, in case you missed any of our news bulletins, or for more updates, you can catch us on Limex World TV or log on to our website on www.tv360nigeria.com. You can also follow us on our social media platforms on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube at TV360Nigeria. On Facebook, we're at TV360 Online. In an effort to prevent a repeat of failures in the global response to the COVID-19 pandemic, member states of the World Health Organization, WHO, have decided to draft and negotiate a treaty to strengthen pandemic prevention, preparedness, and response. The COVID-19 pandemic has put into focus the reality of inequities in population morbidity, mortality, and access to medicines, vaccines, and other crucial equipment between nations, especially between rich and poor countries. The treaty was driven by the need to ensure that communities, government, and all sectors of society within countries and globally are better prepared and protected in order to prevent and respond to future pandemics. A researcher at Wuhan Institute of Virology has claimed China engineered COVID-19 as a bioweapon to purposely infect people. In an exclusive interview, Chao Chao, a researcher from Wuhan, confessed that their superior provided them with four coronavirus strains for testing. Their task was to identify the strain with the greatest ability to infect various species, including humans. These revelations highlight the alleged intention to create a highly contagious virus. Chao Chao's claims, while significant, require further scrutiny and investigation to establish the full truth about the origins and infections and intentions behind the virus creation. We'll take another break here, but stay with us for more stories in business. Welcome back. Let's now join Mary Kanu for Business News. Over to you, Mary.
Many thanks, Simsala. Welcome to Business News. The Central Bank of Nigeria has pegged daily transaction limits to 50,000 naira for contactless payments. In a circular signed by the Director, CBN Payment System Management Department, Musa Jimoh, the Apex Bank said due to the risks associated with contactless payments, verification and authorization would be required for transactions above the limits. In October 2022, the financial regulator issued guidelines to commercial banks, financial institutions and payment service providers on contactless payments in order to promote innovation in the sector. The Apex Bank further said for transactions above limits existed Know Your Customer KYC requirements and limits on the electronic payment channels shall apply. And the federal government has approved the discontinuation of budgetary allocations to professional bodies and councils effective December 31st, 2026. This directive was contained in a circular signed by the Director General of the Budget Office, Ben Akabwezi. Akabwezi said the institutions were now regarded as self-funded organizations and will henceforth be fully responsible for the personnel, overhead and capital expenditures. According to the Director General, the directive was in line with the decision of the Presidential Committee on Salaries and will take effect from December 2026. And that's all on Business News. Simisola, back to you for the rest of the news.
Thank you very much, Mary, for that update. And a 24-hour ceasefire agreed upon in Sudan has been violated as Eid celebrations were unlike any before for people in Sudan suffering from the war for more than 70 days. Residents reported hearing heavy gunfire in parts of the capital, Khartoum, early on Wednesday, as well as artillery and airstrikes, which the Sudanese army launched against the Rapid Support Forces positions. Sudan's conflict has killed at least 2,000 civilians and wounded many more, while the International Organization for Migration, IOM, estimates that almost 2 million people have been displaced internally and more than 600,000 have fled to neighboring countries. Well, it's time now for entertainment report on News Now.
Social media is abuzz with various emotions and reactions following a new claim that Nigerian singer David Adeleke, popularly known as Davido, impregnated a United States businesswoman, Anita Brown, and has refused to acknowledge the pregnancy. Anita first came to the public's knowledge on Sunday with claims of being in a relationship and pregnant with a singer child, resurfaced a few hours ago with receipts to prove her claims. Anita in a social media outburst stated that she first met the singer in 2017 while in Dubai and they dated on and off until the pandemic when she was in a long-distance relationship. She released screenshots of chats between her and Davido, who not only affirmed having unprotected sex with her, but also chats where he asked her to end the pregnancy like every other girl in his past that helped to lighten his problems. Her receipt also shows conversation between her and clerks, who promised to advise Davido on taking responsibility for the child upon its arrival. Michael Owusu-Addo, Ghanaian rapper popularly known as Sakodie, has refuted claims by actress Yvonne Nelson that he impregnated her and made her terminate the pregnancy. In her recently released memoir titled I'm Not Yvonne Nelson, the actress dug deep into her life as an entertainer, detailing her past relationships with men in the industry. Allegations against the musician were detailed in page 88 to 95 of the book. However, reacting to her claims, Sakodie released a diss track titled Try Me, where he refuted Nelson's account of the story. Contrary to allegations in the book, Sakodie stated that he had asked her to keep the baby even though he was not ready to father a child as at that time, but she however chose to abort because she was still schooling. That's it on the entertainment segment of News Now. Tamilore Akinkole, TV360 Nigeria.
Bayern Munich have announced they have decided not to renew their sponsorship arrangement with Qatar Airways, which had long been controversial because of human rights concerns in the Gulf country. In a joint statement, both sides say the contract would end by mutual agreement on June 30 after a five-year partnership. Germany's biggest club had long faced criticism for its ties to Doha and the state-owned carrier in relation to alleged human rights issues, particularly surrounding the 2022 World Cup in Qatar. Bayer's new CEO, Jan-Christian Driessen, says the team and Qatar Airways have worked together successfully and learned from each other. And that's all on the News Now. Thank you very much for watching. I am Simisola Ajikun.